After we focus on the climate data and window configuration for the calculation of external loads within the cooling load calculation in the last video, this time I will show you how to consider usage profiles and internal loads. Usage profiles indicate how the rooms in our projects are used. Temperature profiles, on the other hand, assign the desired temperatures to these individual rooms by specifying temperatures for cooling and heating. The assignment of internal loads then again takes into account the room-specific entries by, for example, people, electrical devices or machines. Now you have two possibilities to assign these values in your project. If you have already stored the information in your CAP model, you can simply read it into linear building in the course of our building detection. Within the linear properties, you can assign the corresponding load profiles to each MEP space. In addition to specifying the target heating and cooling temperatures, you can define additional loads via the room types. Here, you either use existing configuration or create new profiles. The room types then contain, for example, the person loads as well as the occupation and lighting plans for the different room types and can then be transferred to linear building. To transfer these values, activate the Load Profiles from Room Types checkbox in the building detection, and then all values from the model will be integrated into the cooling load calculation. If you have not defined this information in the model, you can do this comfortably in linear building. Let's start here with the usage profiles where we specify when the rooms are used and how in relation to the loads. In VDI 2078, these are divided into working and non-working days. In ASHRAE, we just define the working days. I've already created three usage profile sets here and assigned them to the corresponding rooms. So here we have a general usage profile where we specify that the assigned rooms are used between 8 a.m. and 5 p.m. on workdays. On non-working days, the usage is significantly lower here. The situation is different for the server rooms, which on the one hand have a all-time based load because they are also operated at night and on non-working days, but also the usage during working hours is more intensive. I have assigned another profile to the cafeteria rooms where the usage is highest during the break time. You can set this simple by moving these handles here in this dialog or give them a value below. For example, I could specify that the cafeteria usage is already at 100% at noon. Next, we will look at setting up the temperature profiles. Depending on the use of the room, the requirements for heating and cooling temperature can be different. So in the general temperature profile set, I have specified that on working days, cooling should start at temperatures higher than 25 degrees and heating should start at temperatures below 20 degrees. On non-working days, the tolerances here are slightly higher. For the server rooms, I set the temperature between 15 and 20 degrees at all times. As a last setting, let's have a look at the assignment of the internal loads. To avoid having to make the settings for each room individually, it is advisable to create so-called room groups and then assign the corresponding loads to them in one step. You can also choose multiple rooms by the manual selection and then assign loads to them together, but we are going to use the room groups here. I've already assigned most of the rooms to groups. I will show you how to do this quickly and easily. After you've created a room group here, like I did for the conference rooms, you can then select the rooms from the room list you want to have in this group. To do this, you can also use the filter and thus limit the selection in order to quickly find the appropriate rooms, especially in large projects. Then just use the checkboxes and the rooms become part of the group. Once you have done this, you can assign the loads for all rooms in the group in the next step. Simply select the group and start assigning the loads by clicking into the table. So let's start with the persons and enter 6 persons for the conference rooms here. As usage profile, we choose the general usage profile we defined before. For the person load, we can then either enter a load value manually or select the corresponding values from ASHRAE or VDI 2078. In this case, I decide to use the moderate active office work from ASHRAE. Next, I create loads for the lighting. Here I enter now once manually a value of 8 watts per square meter and name this load with LED. Of course, you can also use values from the respective standards here as well. Analogously, you can then also do this for the machinery and devices, as well as provide information on infiltration and material throughputs. I have already done this here and have also already assigned the corresponding loads for all the other room groups. You will then find these information also at the room level, and you can edit these values here as well if necessary. Once all the necessary information has been entered, we can look at the results. You are receiving cooling load calculation results for the entire project, as well as for each room and each floor. In the results dialog, we can see all the calculated loads. The total cooling load can be divided into the cooling load through ventilation and the cooling load through other systems. We can also display all individual load components graphically here. In addition, we see the curve of the solar radiation and all data once again in the table form. All results are then displayed in detail in the printouts. Here we find the project overview, as well as all results in the room list, and of course also all detailed results for each individual room. Finally, we take a look at the results of the annual simulation, which is a special part of the calculation according to VDI 2078. Here we can find both the cooling and heating capacities over the entire year, and if we take a look at the overview page, we can also see these annual heating and cooling capacities as well as the operating hours of the system. The dynamic cooling load calculation was linear. That's workflow instead of workaround.